360 to 380 million years ago, during the late Devonian period, there lived a huge species of predatory fish that grew up to 20 feet long and weighed up to a ton. That fish was Dunkleosteus, and it lived far before the dinosaurs did. The Devonian was a period on planet Earth where fish reigned king, and the king of all kings was Dunkleosteus. But for the next few minutes, let's imagine a hypothetical timeline where old Dunkaroo didn't go extinct when it did. What would the cause and effect have been? That's what we are going to talk about on today's episode of Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that imagines the impossible. I'm Charlotte Dobre. This is where I remind you to smash the thumbs up, subscribe button, notification bell, and make sure you ask us a question in the comments below. Even though it was basically a giant fish, Dunkleosteus was one of the most terrifying predators ever to exist. It kind of looked like a submarine, but in the shape of a fish. It was armored and had extremely thick, muscly skin that was difficult for its enemies to puncture. It also had a distinctly shaped mouth, a beak, somewhat like that of a parrot. It didn't have teeth, but it had an extremely powerful bite and two bony plates, and with them could bite down at a force of 6,000 pounds, right up there with the megalodon's bite force. Its jaws were so powerful that they killed instantly and could easily slice through a large victim and break them clean in half. Experts think that its mouth was so big it may have just swallowed its prey whole. That being said, Dunkleosteus was believed to have been a relatively slow swimmer. Dunkleosteus fossils have been discovered all over the world, in North America, in Africa, and in Europe. Interestingly, it lived at the same time as the coelacanth, a species of fish that didn't go extinct and still exists today. Granted, they are rare, but they can be found off the east coast of Africa near the Comoro Islands, as well as off the coast of Indonesia and in the Indian Ocean. So why did Dunkleosteus go extinct and not coelacanth? Well, right around the time of its extinction, oxygen levels in the ocean dropped significantly. A drop in oxygen means that the big fish that needed that oxygen wouldn't be able to survive, and neither would much of the marine life. This mass extinction killed off between 79% and 87% of all marine species, including Dunkleosteus. For many, many millions of years after that, smaller fish flourished until marine dinosaurs came about. At the same time, at the end of the late Devonian period, that was when the race to the land began. Vertebrates began to leave the water, like the ancestor of all four limbed vertebrates, tetrapods. Their fins eventually turned into legs. In the hypothetical world where Dunkleosteus didn't go extinct, the thing that was responsible for killing it off would not have happened. Oxygen levels in the world's oceans would have had to remain at high levels for Dunkleosteus not to go extinct, and that would have set off a domino effect. One of the main reasons why a drop in oxygen occurred is because land plants began to flourish. These land plants created nutrients that got swept up into the oceans and was then consumed by algae, which multiplied. But then, when the algae died, bacteria took over, and that's what consumed all the remaining oxygen and caused the end of the Devonian period. Without this drop in oxygen, Dunkleosteus and other species of giant fish would have continued to thrive, and the rest of marine life would too. The Devonian period saw an impressive array of different species of fish unlike anything that exists today. Our oceans would have been extremely lush, with vegetation to create the oxygen. Perhaps if there were no drop in oxygen, the Devonian period would have continued on for even longer, or perhaps not have ended at all. There might not have been a race to the land, and eventually that might have meant that humans wouldn't exist. Sure, there may have been a race to the land at some point, but that wouldn't have occurred until much later. If the race to land didn't happen when it did, who knows how evolution would have been affected by this. But one thing is for certain, the world's inhabitants would look a lot different than they do, perhaps even aquatic looking in nature, or amphibious. The Earth's ocean would become even more and more diverse with every passing millennia. Perhaps even humanoid sea-dwelling beings would have evolved from some types of fish. You know, like that dude from Shape of Water? Yeah, kinda like that. But these humanoids would still have to worry about Dunkleosteus and other large predatory fish that would not have gone extinct. But as I previously stated, Dunkleosteus was not a very fast swimmer, so maybe these humanoids would just have to pick up the pace a little bit. Of course, we don't have an exact reason why all of these changes in evolution occurred. It was likely a number of contributing factors. But as soon as you change one thing about the course of history, especially something as vital as oxygen levels in the ocean, a strange timeline begins to take shape, one where humans might not exist entirely. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobre, and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you like this video, you'll love What If Terror Birds Didn't Go Extinct, clickable on the screen right now. Don't forget to subscribe to notifications by clicking the bell, and I will see you in another episode of Life's Biggest Questions.